She is an indefatigable champion for peace, justice, and equity. She is relentless in her determination to see the UN deliver for real people in real places facing real challenges. She's a mother of six and a grandmother of two, and she's maybe mother of another 17 if we count the SDGs. She is a very dear friend, and she is, of course, the Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations, Ms. Amina Mohammed.
Hello, people. So it's three grandchildren and the fourth on the way. But dearest Ted, Elizabeth, Excellencies, friends, and of course, ladies and gentlemen, it really is wonderful to be here after so long and to also be part of the welcome to all of you for the United Nations Foundation Leadership Award. And I'd like to give a very special shout out to the incredible permanent representatives of the United Nations who really do the work of trying to keep us together. I probably get in trouble for this, but especially the women. I'd like to begin by acknowledging the UN Foundation's tremendous contributions to the United Nations, its vital work, our shared priorities. And ours really is a unique and a remarkable partnership. We've traveled a long, long way together since Ted Turner's historic $1 billion gift, and we must not remember that, as Liz just talked about a third, what would that be of some millionaires, billionaires today? But his gift to support the UN and its causes over two decades. Most recently, the Foundation played an instrumental role in supporting the preparations and the successful Transforming Education Summit in September. The Foundation's steadfast leadership and commitment to supporting the UN, reaching new audiences, building new constituencies, and promoting multi-stakeholder solutions to the most pressing needs that we have in our global challenges. It is profound and it is greatly appreciated. Tonight's gala event is first and foremost about celebrating the achievements of remarkable individuals and organizations being honored for their exemplary contributions to a safer, a more just, and certainly for us, a more inclusive world. A world where we live in solidarity and with human dignity. I could not be more delighted by tonight's extraordinary honorees, who include, I would say, the most inspiring leader of our time, Prime Minister Motley of Barbados. And every one of us that has heard her speak knows that she certainly speaks truth to power so effortlessly. This is not talking points. She gets up there and she just says it. So thank you for being who you are. The incomparable Forrest Whitaker, the wonderful Mia Kami, and our friends and colleagues in the UN Population Fund, led by the amazing Natalia Cannon. I'd like to congratulate you all and thank you for your incredible service to humanity. Before we settle into a wonderful dinner and a night of inspiration, and this certainly will be one, I'd like to remind you of what you already know. Our world is absolutely amazing, but it is in big trouble. We're facing crisis after crisis. People are hurting and our planet is burning. Hunger is rising and inequality is growing dramatically. War is raging and human rights are under attack. Billions of people trying to struggle in the recovery from the economic impact of COVID. They now face a record inflation, together with skyrocketing food, energy, and fertilizer bills. So we are undoubtedly at a grim moment in our history. And solving these crises calls for solidarity across our world. And that is entirely impossible, but it's up to us to do the right thing by our human family and by our planet, our home. Together we have the collective knowledge, the networks, the means, the capacities to transform this world and achieve the Sustainable Development Goals by 2030. I know it doesn't look so good now, but when I look around the faces in this room, the friends and colleagues that we have here, we know it's possible. As Liz had said, next year we take stock of the halfway mark, and perhaps one of the most compelling reasons for hope lies in the current generation of young people. Everywhere, they are challenging the status quo and driving change on climate, on the environment, racial justice, human rights, gender equality, and access to decent work and living wages. Young people understand at a fundamental level that we must create a more sustainable and inclusive world in which we do live in harmony with nature and, more importantly, with each other. They're always holding governments to account and corporations accountable, and they're unparalleled in human history. So let's show our faith and our trust in those young leaders. Let's secure a genuine intergenerational transition that would lay more solid foundations for future generations. In closing, we must act together in solidarity. Future generations are not going to remember today's speeches, but they will remember the actions that we take. So let us keep the promise of the SDGs for Fatima on the banks of Lake Chad, for Valora in the Amazon, Latin America, and for Cordell in the islands of the Caribbean. Thank you.